What's up, guys? Zach Scott here, showing you Fix-It Felix Jr., a game derived from the Disney movie Wreck-It Ralph. I'm playing the Flash-based version, which is freely available on Disney's website, but there's also an iOS version for iPhones, iPads, and whatnot. Here we go. I am Felix Jr. here, or Felix, I don't know. Basically, the game works. I climb this little skyscraper that's in Nice Land, and Wreck-It Ralph up top destroys stuff. So he destroys it, I fix it. That's how it works. This game was released to promote the movie Wreck-It Ralph, and I'll be talking about the game, its mechanics, as well as the movie from which it comes from. Okay, this is really cool. Right there, you see? That's one of the power-ups of Pi, and basically what it does is it lets me fix windows really quickly. So when I go up here, I'm immediately going to the more difficult to fix windows to fix them first until the power-up runs out. There's a lot of stuff going on right now. Let's see. So basically, I'm just fixing some stuff. You see all the obstacles here. I fixed it. Level one over. That was only like two little elevations. And once you win, Felix gets the medal and a pie, and the villagers throw Ralph off the top. And he's back to do it again. Now this time it's taller. It's the skyscraper either gets taller each level or it's a new skyscraper each level. It's hard to tell. But yeah, he keeps breaking windows. I fix them. I dodge the obstacles. And you see here, either one or two panes can be broken. And basically, one pane just requires one little click. Two panes require two. And some of the panes that are broken are like completely gone, or they're half gone. Either way, it's the same. I think that's just for aesthetics. So yeah, Wreck-It Ralph keeps punching. Bricks fall. I just try to dodge those. I go get the pie power-ups when they're available. I fix them really quick. I can do two broken panes in one stroke, which is why, once again, you'll see me doing that. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. Anyway. So, other than bricks, you know, I don't care. I guess I don't care about fixing wherever the bricks come from. I'm just here to fix the windows. But other than the bricks, you know, the three drop seemingly each time. There are ducks. These ducks, you saw some. They look like they're from Duck Hunt or something. They fly horizontally, and they gradually get, you know, faster and more numerous as the game progresses. The ducks never seem to switch rows. So that's good. at least as far as I've gotten in this game, they never seem to switch rows. See those barriers right there? That little blue barrier. Those can either be horizontal or vertical, and basically they make the game a little bit harder to get to. I mean, not the game. The windows a little bit harder to get to. They can trap me in. You know, if there's a duck on top, you know, and there's a border on the side, I can't get to it. So anyway, what else? Let's see here. I guess every time you saw that I got a life a little bit ago. Every time that I get, I'm gonna dodge this. Okay, there we go. Okay, yep, get in the pie right now. Oh yeah, I'm gonna go fix it quick. I fixed it once again. Yes, they throw him off. He doesn't die though. He lands in a weird, mysterious gray goo. It's not blood unless his blood is gray. Boom, gray goo. No, it's probably a shadow or something. I don't know. Anyway, so yeah, extra life every 50,000 points, apparently. I don't know if this has showed up yet. I haven't really been paying attention. But sometimes, you know, all the elevations here start off with the windows broken. But sometimes you'll start noticing that the windows just start breaking half, like, mid-game, basically. I guess I could talk about the movie a little bit. Let me see. I have a there's a kind of a cast list on Wikipedia. I could look at. You know, I have that on my other screen right here. And here we go. Let's see. It's hard to pull off here. Talking about the movie. Yeah. Well. First, to promote the movie, they actually took this game. And they took Donkey Kong cabinets, refinished them, and they put Fix-It Felix inside. So, and they put that around movie theaters and stuff that people can play. And I think that's pretty cool. One thing you might have seen, my friend Adam, aka Swimming Bird, he has a cool little Minecraft Wreck-It Ralph parody that I've linked to in the annotations, at least. And Wreck-It Ralph is, of course, the villain. And that's kind of what the movie's about. I don't want to talk too much about the movie. Oh, there we go. Got hit with a brick. That was a bad move on my part. So I don't think I've gotten another life. Maybe the I don't know what the maybe I did. I haven't been paying attention too closely. Anyway, fixing some windows. Watch out for this barrier here. Okay. Yep. Like I'm doing good. The ducks. Yeah, there we go. There's my other life. So the it's not every 50,000. I just broke 125 that time. So yeah, the first one's at 50,000. I guess the second one's at 125. So anyway, this one has two rows of see, I don't like that. That brick just hit me. If you stay near the top, you gotta really watch out, because I mean it's gonna pie time. Ah, I missed it. You gotta be joking, kidding me. Anyway, okay. So I think this game accurately reflects like the feel of an 80s arcade. Arcade game, you know, it kind of reminds me a bit of Donkey Kong, and it gives you basically back then it gives you a simple goal, and then they come up with reasons to to not reach the goal, obstacles. The goal is dang it. Okay, I got to be careful here. Let's see how much longer I can stick in. Let's do this. Okay. Oh dang it, I died. Oh well, game over. Thanks so much for watching. I guess I could play again. I guess it wouldn't hurt to play again. I could play one more time for just the sake. The sake of just showing you as much as I can possibly about this. I don't know. See if I can beat my old score. Got three lives again, so that's good. Back in the nice lands, there's a little plane flying in the background that tells me what level it is. Gotta watch out for bricks. What was I saying? Yeah, so I think it kind of reminds me of Donkey Kong a little bit in the fact that, you know, obstacles are coming down. Basically, 80s arcade games were notorious for giving you, like, an obstacle, having a villain be the cause of this obstacle, and then providing a goal. This goal is what I'm saying. And then providing obstacles that prevent you from reaching the goal. Sometimes the obstacles are part of the story, as in the bricks are falling. Sometimes they're not, like the ducks. It's like they would always, like, in the 80s, developers would love to throw in obstacles that had, like, nothing to do with anything. And these ducks, I mean, they're just ducks here. That's just, and there's just barriers here. So anyway, they're also kind of notorious for throwing in random birds, it seems. And this game isn't that hard. I fixed it. This game isn't as hard as I remember 80s games being, though, not at least not in my opinion. Here we go, throw them off, got a medal, got a pie. Goodbye. Now, with talking about the movie Wreck-It Ralph, I don't want to spoil it too much. I never know what people's thresholds for spoilers are, but I do have the Wikipedia pulled up, and I can talk about some of the cast and cameos and stuff, because that's the part that's really interesting. I haven't seen the movie yet. I do plan on seeing it. Adam saw the movie. He said he really liked it. It's a really good, basically a really good video game based movie is basically what he said about it. And right now on Rotten Tomatoes, you know, Wreck-It Ralph has like a critical score of 84%, which usually before I see movies, I definitely make sure that the Rotten Tomatoes critical rating is at least 80%. I've been tricked by that. People, pie. Get it? Yeah, and I'm going to fix these two single broken windows. And then up top here, I'm going to take care of as many of the double broken windows that I can as quickly as I can. Okay. Watch out for that freaking duck or bird. This really reminds me of the Duck Hunt. Like, of course, I guess it's hard to make an 8-bit duck without making it look like Duck Hunt, because ducks look the same. He actually doesn't. The 8-bit Duck Hunt from Nintendo looks, their eyes are big. This duck has like no eyes. So anyway, what was I saying? So yeah. So I've been tricked by that Rotten Tomatoes rating before, but for real, like it, I usually won't go see a movie in the theaters at least if it doesn't at least have an 80%. What else? It has an audience score of 90%, so that's kind of cool. I kind of go by that too. Anyway, the cast is quite diverse. It has John C. Reilly voicing Wreck-It Ralph, who's my villain, who's the guy at the top here. Fix-It Felix is voiced by Jack McBrayer, and he's a Fix-It Felix Jr. All right, fixed it. Gonna throw him off the roof again. Sarah Silverman, I guess, is Vanellope von Schwartz. She's a 9-year-old racer and glitch in the game Sugar Rush. And so this game actually provides This movie has different fictional game characters and also real game characters. And let me just read off a few more of the cast here. We have Mindy Kaling, Adam Carolla. Who else is familiar to me? Jane Lynch. Alan. Is that the guy? It's the Alan. I don't know how to pronounce his name. Tadek. I don't know how to pronounce his name, but I think he was from Firefly. Now here's something funny. Skrillex does a voice. He's the voice of the DJ. Get the pie. Get the pie. Get the pie. Yeah. Skrillex is the voice of the DJ. He also has a song on the movie soundtrack. So that's kind of funny to me. The cameos. Now this is where this game shines. It kind of is in the style of Who Framed Roger Rabbit, in the sense that it gathers animated characters from all different companies. And this movie, Wreck-It Ralph, is heavily rich on cameos. It includes probably the most famous is Bowser from Super Mario Brothers. We have Dr. Eggman from Sonic the Hedgehog. We got Q-Bert from Q-Bert, of course. We got a couple Street Fighters, Chun-Li and Cammy. Some Paperboy, Frogger, a bunch of Dig Dug characters. Let's see. I'm about to hit another extra life, if I can make it. Go up to the next level. Now, these obstacles are getting more and more... Now, I planned on going up that way so that I would be on one side of the obstacle or the other. Okay, gonna go fix this double pane. Gotta watch out for his bricks. Got some single, double. Yeah, I guess you get 500. See, he just broke a window right there. That was one that I already fixed that he just broke. And I can't tell if I got the extra life or not. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I don't know. So yeah, a lot of, it has the paddle from Pong, has Pac-Man and some of the ghosts. So this movie is heavy on the cameos. The producers, at one time they wanted Mario in, but then they couldn't think of a way to fit him in, which is good because Nintendo wanted a really, really high licensing fee for Mario. But not too high for Bowser, I guess. But yeah. Anyway, in case you guys are wondering where I'm playing this, I'm actually playing it on Disney's website. And I'm doing really well. Whoa, almost got hit there. Almost spoke too soon. Let's see. Let's fix. I have a lot of lives. Gotta go. See, that one, I think, broke again. There we go, going up. So, yeah, I'm playing this on Disney's website. And they also have other games. There's, like, Heroes Duty, which was a fictional game feature. Okay, yep. Couldn't do much there. I shouldn't have got myself in that position. This is where it gets harder. The ducks are faster. They're on more than one row. I'm just trying to fix stuff. I'm trying to dodge bricks. I'm trying to maneuver around obstacles. So yeah, they have Heroes Duty and Sugar Rush on the website, which are fictional games that were featured in this movie as well. They're not 8-bit like this. What? Okay, that was a brick. A brick hit me, which sucks. I'm gonna try to do this really quick. So yeah, go check it out. I probably won't be playing those two games. Okay. Yep. Oh, I got myself in a mess. Game over. Well, anyway, thanks so much for watching. I'm Zach Scott. Subscribe if you have not. Please feel free to check out my channel. I play lots of different games. I'll be doing more games of all different sorts. So go ahead and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. And come back next time for more. I'm glad I could do this little game just a one time. For all my longtime viewers, I'm not going to keep playing Fix-It Felix Jr. over and over and over. This is just a one-shot thing. For all the new viewers, thanks for watching. See you around.